Hi there, it's Jamie here at the School of Creative Magic. And I'm here very spontaneously to make a video for you. And I know that I have sort of been here, disappeared, been here, disappeared. And the been here part is that I feel so pulled and called to share with you in this format. It just seems to be a way that we can connect really beautifully about things that are important in our creative lives, for ways that we can remember that our life is our studio and we are artists. And the past 18 months has been incredibly formative and foundational for me and for my work. Many of you know we moved from being Jamie Riddler Studios to forming the School of Creative Magic. I launched a brand new year-long program called The Studio, Your Year of Creative Magic. And I have been in a deep and intensive training to become an embodied leader and a DJ. It's been a lot. It's been amazing. It's been amazing, amazing, amazing. And I feel like it's laying a foundation for so many incredible things to come. And now I've been deep in this DJ training since February. And you can tell it's not February anymore. And now I can feel, I still have several weeks to go, but we're emerging. We're emerging. And I'm finding myself sort of between trapezes. Have you ever had this experience where you're leaving one thing and moving into another? And I can feel myself and all the sadness and joy and celebration and grieving that this experience that's been very all-encompassing is coming to a close, and also all the phenomenal things that are on the horizon. This DJ training really has been my devotion. I know many of you know about my program, Devotion, this 3-month artist immersion, this intensive experience between you and your art, and you and yourself and your identity as an artist. And for me, this program has been my version of that, really dedicated to honing a craft that I knew in no way before I started. I've never had my hands on a DJ controller. Do we even know what a DJ controller is? Right? Like, there's just like we've seen decks, probably in videos. And so, learning how to use one of those, learning how to conceptualize a set, learning how to make good choices about our music, and then also learning how to create beautiful and seamless transitions. So, a brand new, like honing a tangible, practical skill, then also learning the artistry, because my intention with the DJing is to create dance journeys for people who long to bring more of themselves alive, who have whole parts of their creative self that aren't expressed. That if we can bypass our brain and get into our bodies with the support of music, and music that's designed to take us on a journey into ourselves and come out the other side with fresh insight. That's what I want to do. I want to do it with you. And that's why I've been in this program, is preparing for that. So, learning the artistry of crafting that journey. And then also learning what my own artistic voice is like within this brand new medium. Have you ever had that experience where you're making art and you look at your art and you go, wow, I did not know that my style or my voice or my expression would look like that. Like, I just didn't know. Sometimes for me, that's been, or even sometimes you can be self-conscious about it. I certainly have that. I know that when I am enjoying drawing, for example, I tend to draw things that are cute, happy. When I'm painting, I tend to lean towards something epic. And same with collage work, I'm usually looking at something mythical, like my minotaur here, something mythical that has some like presence. And so who am I as a DJ? What am I going to discover about my voice in the world of music? What songs will come out is like, what colors will come out? And so that will continue to be, that'll be an ongoing journey. Just like as artists, we continue to develop and grow. But I've definitely learned that I like some funkiness, that I like some edginess, that I like some heart stirring. And I think what I really like underneath all the musical choices is the full range of human emotion. So, you know, I was talking to one of my coaches in this DJ program about being a woman my age doing this, and that I sometimes bring more edge than people might expect to my mixes, or more intensity. And one of the things I said to him was, do you know how many women my age are walking around with intensity they have nowhere to express? Passion or rage or heartbreak, like that's dialed up not to 11, but to 1100. And we have nowhere to let it out. And so the dance floor is a place. The dance floor is a place to let that intensity out. I have a big feelings. I have an intensity of feelings. One of the things I've had an intensity of feelings around, and we've talked about this a little bit here, is aging. And I want to thank everybody. When a while back, when I did a video about how I have felt like retreating for a variety of reasons, I'm emerging from that too, I believe. But, you know, I was struggling with aging. My dad, we spent a year really focused on my dad, who was fighting cancer and then passed away. And then before that, COVID. And so it's taken a while for me to kind of come up and be back and present and feel rooted and grounded outside of my community. So I feel very grounded within the School of Creative Magic, and with those of you who are my students and my classes, like that felt like a place of strength and excitement and passion. And it was the outsideness that felt a little wobbly for me. But when I shared that, so many of you came back and shared your own experience with aging, your own struggle with aging. And one of you, Anne, hi, Anne, said, why don't you teach a class on this? And I thought, I don't know how I could teach a class on this because I'm so in it. Like I'm not out the other side with something to offer to teach. And then I thought, okay, but Jamie, how do you teach almost all your classes? Is like, let's put this thing in the middle and let's talk about it. Like, what do you think? What do you think? What do you think? When you hear what somebody else thinks, what resonates in you? What clarity is coming? What do you want to try out saying? Sometimes I'll start exploring an idea and I'll hear myself talking. And then I'll realize, oh, this has the ring of truth. And then sometimes I'll say something, I go, oh, that's a lie. By which I mean, I'm not intentionally lying, but it's like something that maybe came from the culture or came from my past or somebody once told me. But when I say it, I recognize, no, that's actually doesn't belong to me, or I don't find that to be true. And it allows me to start to let it go. So that led to this great inspiration, which led to why I was here today, because I am running a symposium this fall, a symposium in a class called the Crone Conversations. And what it's going to be is between the full corn moon and the fall equinox, I'm going to offer a series of interviews with older women about what this experience of aging has been like for them. And I even got four of my DJ colleagues who are also older women. Like, I was amazed. I really thought I would be it in that community, but I was not. And I'm so thankful. I made such strong connections, and it was so moving and empowering to see other women taking on something so different at this stage in life. And they're going to create mixes inspired by their relationship to the crone and to aging. So we'll have interviews and we'll have mixes. And afterwards, a class, a 4-week class that really is designed for you to have a chance to talk, for you to have a chance to listen, to partner with other, we'll be doing breakout rooms, to chat with other women, to explore the questions, to process what came up for you during the interviews. And registration for that will open in August. And I'm not ready to announce the women that I'll be interviewing yet, but this morning, So in the past couple of days, I've gotten some yeses and had some conversations with women who've been a part of my life, my online life, for over a decade, maybe well over a decade. And I have to tell you, there was something in my heart that was like, because we're all getting older together, right? We all started out in that heyday of blogging. And we're all getting older. And to look around at these women and to meet in conversation and to have them say, oh yeah, I want to talk about this. I want to talk about this with you. I want it just for the first time gave me a sense of community for the conversation about being a woman getting older. And the way that tenderized my heart lets me know that these conversations matter, and that I want you to have that sense of connection and community and real conversations, a chance for us to sit and tell our stories, and in telling our stories, finding ways to tell a new one, one that feels good, one that feels good and right and true in our hearts and in our bodies, one where we don't say, that's a lie, but rather we go, yeah, that's how I want to grow older. Not that's how I should want to feel grow older. I have lots of opinions about how cool I should be, how like fierce I should be, how like strong I should be. And that's not how I felt at all. At all. I felt loss. I felt grieving. I felt, most of all, I felt disoriented. I couldn't see myself. And this is only the beginning, right? Like, years and years from now, I will look even more different than I look now. So how can I see me as me? This is a part of the question for me. Part of why this sort of to me is relevant in the context of my life as my studio and I am an artist is, well, one, certainly the idea of recreating ourselves, transforming, but mainly where this is taking me is what I call given circumstances. And that comes from my theater background. So when you get a play and you're going to be in it, or you're going to direct, or you're going to, you know, one of the first things you do is look at the script for the given circumstances. What's being told to you as already existing. And those are things you honor, right? So if this character is 27, if this happens in a bar if this is told in a 24-hour period. Now, yes, directors take lots of liberties with these, and usually those are conscious choices that you have a reason you can defend that choice with. But your starting point is, this is what I know. And then all the rest is what I, Jamie, as an actor, say, can bring to it. And I have found this an incredibly useful tool for life, is to think, what are my given circumstances? And all of us have a different set that have limitations, that have privileges, that have just, it's innumerable, the amount of given circumstances we have, and they're unique to you. And then also some are shared with your generation or people who shared the same cultural context, the same race, the same gender, the same, we have some things that are shared, but we're all working with a unique sort of mosaic of given circumstances. So, but that's our starting point. It's like, okay, these are my given circumstances. Now, what can I do? And that's how I'm thinking about aging. Okay, I am a woman of a certain age. Now, what can I do? That'll be some of what we are exploring together in the Crone Conversations. I hope you'll join me for that. Okay, I hope there was something in this for you today. There's so much percolating. And now that I am emerging, I hope to be here more often. Though I know we're diving into a really, we've got the Crone Conversations coming up in September. The class for the Crone Conversations will be in October. We're preparing for another year of creative magic. So if you didn't get to join the studio last year, I hope you'll join me for that next year. I'm going to start doing dance events, which I hope you will attend. And some of those events will be a part of the studio. So you'll get some dancing for sure if you become a member of that. I'm going to run devotion in the winter of 2025. So there's a lot of wonderful things. And it's been, oh, and the studio yearbook, of course, where the fall edition is coming out very soon. By the way, if you join the studio, you get all four. You get a studio yearbook, which is my seasonal fill in the blank creative journal that really is like a studio in a journal. You get all four for next year if you join the studio. We have a wait list open. So much going on. But mostly what inspired me today was my own feeling of the power of connection and community and my desire to invite you in to experience that in the Crone Conversations or in any of the offerings at the School of Creative Magic. I'm so glad you're here. I'm so glad I could be here today. I look forward to lots more creative conversations. Remember, your life is your studio and you are an artist. I believe in you. I'll see you soon.